I was very protective with my mom, the firstborn, you know, on my mom's side, and I was big, you know, big brother, and you know, there was fighting. They got into an argument, and I told him, you know, hey, dad, ease up, and then he said, you know, his direct words, like, nigga, I ain't your daddy. You know, you want to know who your daddy is. You want to know who your real daddy is. Your real daddy is Dr. Dre.
Yes. I'm jaded, my mental.
Yes.
Sick as the streets. I'm running shit. These niggas sick at my feet. Know they sick of defeat. These pussy niggas is beat. Like the pussies I beat. That's something you can't retweet. That's something you can't report. I talk money. That's something you can't retort. I ball talk like
Oh, yeah, this is the hot spot.
And niggas get smoked in the hood like
new. It's a funny story, man. I was living it out, living out in La Habra. And I had a bad experience of a haircut, and I told him if he can fix it, you'll be my barber. And he fixed it, man. My hairline was like back here, like a LeBron James or something, you know. My childhood was like any other childhood growing up in Compton. It was definitely a lot of trials and tribulations. It was times on this same street that we driving down. You know, I was running away. It was a Mexican and Black riot, and you know, I was running. I'm gonna actually take you guys to the fence where, you know, right before I almost got shot. It's right, I jumped this fence right here at, it's called Kelly Park right here. And I ran through here, and it was chasing me all through here. I have to say it was actually, about like the age of 10. You know, I was real big on, like, you know, the Pac, Biggie, Wu-Tang, Nas. And then, of course, when I found out who my father was, back before then was N.W.A. and like Ice-T. I was a big Eric B. and Rakim fan too. I was all into it. It was hip hop. I loved it. You know, back in the day, we had the thing called the Box, and I would just order videos on there and videos I wasn't supposed to look at and everything, but. And that's how I got inspired, and I started writing things down and trying to rhyme as a kid, and just the inspirations came from, like I said, like I wanted to be more of a lyricist, like how Wu-Tang was. That was really my inspiration. I wanted to be different, and not just I'm not gonna say average, but just not a regular rapper. You know what I mean? I wanted to talk about life stories and just different experiences, even if I didn't go through it, just different experiences that I seen growing up, and that's how I do my music. I was the age of 12. My father that raised me got into an argument with my mom, and it was one of those, you know, I was very protective with my mom, the firstborn, you know, on my mom's side, and I was big, you know, big brother, and you know, there was fighting. They got into an argument, and I told him, you know, hey, dad, ease up. And then he said, you know, his direct words, like, nigga, I ain't your daddy. You know, you want to know who your daddy is. You want to know who your real daddy is. Your real daddy is Dr. Dre. So from there, at the age of 12, is when I found out, you know, and I was on. I felt like a void in my life. You know, like something I had to fulfill. It's me and my father for the first time. Well, right now we're in Compton, California, right by the courthouse. Compton High is right here. Through a rough jungles part of Compton. See, this is the side where all the a lot of Crips are at. You know, you got Samoans out here. Little bit of everything all over here.
Those bring back memories coming back here?
Yeah, one second. Damn, I gotta get me a water. It definitely was a real big mix of emotions. I don't even think words can really describe it, so I'll do the best way I can. I mean, finding out that your father is a legend for the first time is really one of those things that I don't think, you know, any 12-year-old could, like manage or understand and just comprehend basically in their mind. I wanted to meet him when I found out, but my mom was still with my father that raised me, and you know, he didn't want that. He didn't want Dre in my life. That's not something he wanted. You know, he told my mom, like, you know, this, you know, I'm his dad, and you know, it ain't no reason for him to meet him. So when they broke up, when they split up at the age of 15, was when I started pursuing, trying to meet Dre. And believe it or not, it was hard to find him. And when I finally got in touch with his attorneys, we took a DNA test. And of course it came back 99.9%. He is the father, you know, I look just like him. So, I mean, it is what it is from there. And we met, and it's definitely just been keeping this thing going. Man, it was definitely a crazy experience. You know, just leading up to it, you know, just talking to him on the phone for the first time, and you know, you could feel the energy through the phone. Like, man, this is, you know, I think we both was nervous. You know, it was like, man, you know, it's like looking in the mirror, and you know, seeing them face to face. We met at a Sky Bar in Hollywood for the first time, and it's one of those things, like, you know, I mean, it's really undescribable. Like, the best way I can describe it is like meeting your favorite basketball player or football player, whatever it is, or musician, whatever it is, for the first time, and being right in front of them and getting to sit down and talk to them and touch them and, you know who it is and have a drink with them, even though I shouldn't have at 20, but I had to. And just that moment, the feeling was it was epic. It's indescribable, like I said. And we sat down, and like I said, we couldn't stop staring at each other. You know, we would stare and then stop staring and stare. After we met at the Sky Bar, we actually went to the studio, at Encore Studio. And you know, I rode with them down there, and that's when they was working on Get Rich or Die Trying, the 50 Cent album. The first time we met, we shook hands, looked at each other, sat down, and then we couldn't even look at each other. Then we couldn't look at each other because we looked so much alike. It was kind of like I said, the energy and attention was there. It was like sweating bullets in there. You know, it was so much tension, and my mom actually was in between us, and it was just like it was monumental. You know, is the best way I can describe it. Right. It's the street that I grew up on. This house right here, 1208, is where that's the house that I grew up in. Actually, used to live in LA, and nah, that's okay. It's actually a nice street. You know what I mean? You see the difference from going through different parts of Compton. This street is a lot more a nicer street, and I mean, things happen, you know, before they, you know, now they got speed bumps. Some people, we drive by, is going through here, but now they got the speed bumps in here. And there's different things like that. You know, we used to be running through these alleys right here, you know, as kids doing what kids do, you know. And this is right here. We're gonna let it look at it.
Where the west side at? Where the west side? Where the east side at? Where the east side? Where the south side at? Where
what's
the
up,
south
my nigga?
Side? Where the south side? Yeah.
Out here, out here, just little shoes out there. Yeah, it's been a minute.
Let's go. Let's go slipping, champions
Bring back memories, man, like crazy. That's a story.
It's all those old friends.
Huh?
All those old friends.
Yeah, all old friends. Some of them, you know, some people be hating, some people, you know.
Seems like it's all love to me.
Huh?
Seems like it's all love to me from what I see.
I mean, you know, they must love Dre, you know. Gotta have love for that, right? Different when, you know, the crazy thing is different when your father is a billionaire, and from growing up out here to now my father's a billionaire, so people don't know how to respect that, you know what I mean? And they look at it like, oh, he must have, you know, crazy money too. So, you know, it's like you walking around, you're a target now, you know what I mean?
Everybody getting hell, it's that la la la. I lean with it, Ciroc with it, lean with it, Ciroc with it. Lean with it, Ciroc with it. If you need it, girl, to show up in the spot with it. California smoke that la 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 la. New York we smoke it la 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 la. ATL twist the L's of that la la la.
But I'm here to set the record straight about me being spoiled. That's definitely not the case. I don't ask for shit from my father. I don't want nothing from my dad. When I met him, it was different. I was a kid. He got me a car and some cash, but that was pretty much for my birthday. Other than that, after that, it was just really just birthdays, because I wasn't asking for no handouts. I didn't really want nothing from him. I just wanted time spent with him. And, you know, just coming up, but you know, I asked him, you know, I never would ask him, you know, to help me out in this business. Cause one thing he always told me was, you know, you got the name run with it. And just by him giving, you know, me having that birthright of the name, which that helped me push myself and, you know, just as a business person, get everything from everybody else. Oh my gosh.
We're getting good now.
Oh my gosh, I don't even know. Oof. In the past, at the age of 16, I had my first job. I was selling a newspaper. I felt like I was getting pimped because they would drop me off and, you know, I'll go door to door selling the newspaper and getting people to sign up and I was actually good at it, you know. Like from age of 15 to 16, you know, I was on and off jobs. I couldn't keep a job, like not even 90 days. Worked at IKEA, Chuck E. Cheese. I worked at everywhere, security jobs. And yeah, I was always getting fired or doing something stupid. The last time I worked for somebody was at a cell phone shop. And you know, I was just hooking other people up, you know, with cell phone lines, and I ain't even had a service like that. But it was through a friend. He hired me, and I was just trying to make money, and just on a day to day thing, and just hustling. And I always tried to figure out another way. If I was working somewhere, how could I make more money? Whether it was like, you know, at jobs like IKEA, you know, finding a discount, and you know. Using my employee discount and making some side cash and things like that. And always ended up getting in trouble for it. So could never keep a job. And I knew it just wasn't me to have a regular 9-to-5. It was up to me to do something greater on a bigger level and just evolve myself and be my own self-employed business.
I thought you would have been the perfect person to play young Dre on Straight Outta Compton, so I was surprised.
I mean, the Straight Outta Compton thing is, you know, just growing up in Compton, you know, I didn't know my pops, and you know, we live a few streets from each other, but the best man got the part, you know. He's a great actor. He went to school for it, and you know, I want my pops to be seen in the best light, so. I didn't feel some type of way at all about that. You know, a lot of people was like, well, why aren't you in it? And, you know, feel some type of way. I can't wait to see the movie, actually. I want to see exactly, you know, how, you know, everybody portrayed their the characters. I know, you know, Cube's son is in it, and you know, just that's just the same thing. Like Eazy-E not getting, you know, Lil Eazy not being able to pay, being able to play his pops, you know. But that was, you know, that's, it is what it is, you know. It's one of those things, you want the thing, you want them to be painted in the best light. And that's what it was for me.
Got any favorite food spots that you liked going to when you were younger that's around here?
McDonald's. I'm just joking. Product of my DNA is going to be my, just a life story, basically what you've seen, right? You know, just me taking you guys through Compton and me growing up and finding out that I'm Dr. Dre's son, and just the whole aspects of that, just reality, just knowing who I am as a person, from going from Hood Surgeon to Curtis Young, and just understanding my worth and my values and what I want in life, you know, and what I want for me. And then it's gonna be, you know, things like, you know, the fun party stuff, like I said earlier, good feel music, and just a new trend for hip hop.
Everybody getting hell, it's that la la la. I lean with it, Ciroc with it, lean with it, Ciroc with it, lean with it, Ciroc with it. If you need it, girl, to show up in the spot with it. California smoke that la 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 la. New York, we smoking la 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 la. ATL, twist the L's of that la la la. Everybody getting hell.